Welcome to St James's Church for our online worship this week. Reverend Vicky here with you today, and it's a pleasure and a privilege to be with you, to worship with you, and to lead you through the service this week. Let's begin with a couple of great praise songs. So we invite you to come. Now is the time to worship. And then as we consider the sacrifice that Jesus made for each one of us. In Jesus, once again, I think upon your sacrifice. To praise your name. To give thanks for your love for each one of us. So, Father God, would you prepare our hearts and our minds to hear more of you, to know more of your love, and for you to, by your Spirit, draw us ever closer to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Come just as you are. Come, Jesus Christ, I think upon your sacrifice. You became nothing, poured out to death many times. I've wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. In that place once again. Once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you. Once again I pour out my life. Jesus Christ, I think upon your sacrifice. You became nothing, poured out to death many times. I've wondered at your gift of life, and I'm in that place once again. Once again. Once again I look upon the cross where you died. I'm humbled by your mercy and I'm broken inside. Once again I thank you. Once again I pour out.
You are exalted.
Now you are exalted to the highest place. King of the heavens, where one day I'll bow. But for now, I marvel at this saving grace. Once again I
It is by God's grace that we gather as his children, and we lead into a time of confession because of God's love, his mercy, and his redemption. If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sin, God is faithful and just to forgive us our sin and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Almighty God, we name our sin before you today, the darkness that colours our lives and the lies we choose to believe. We confess the wrong we have done and the good we have turned away from. Lord, in your mercy, forgive us and cleanse us, that we may walk in the light of your truth and demonstrate your love in our lives. In Jesus' name, amen. Almighty God, you hate nothing that you have made, and forgive the sins of all those who are truly sorry. May you create and make in us new and repentant hearts, that we, lamenting our sins and acknowledging our brokenness, may receive from you, the God of all mercy, perfect forgiveness and peace. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our reading today is taken from the Gospel of Mark, chapter 7, verses 24 to 37. The faith of a Gentile woman. Then Jesus left Galilee and went north to the region of Tyre. He didn't want anyone to know which house he was staying in, but he couldn't keep it a secret. Right away, a woman who had heard about him came and fell at his feet. Her little girl was possessed by an evil spirit, and she begged him to cast out the demon from her daughter. Since she was a Gentile, born in Syrian Phoenicia, Jesus told her, "First, I should feed the children, my own family, the Jews. It isn't right to take food from the children and throw it to the dogs." She replied, "That's true, Lord, but even the dogs under the table are allowed to eat the scraps from the children's plates." "Good answer," he said. "Now go home, for the demon has left your daughter." And when she arrived home, she found her little girl lying quietly in bed, and the demon was gone. Jesus heals a deaf man. Jesus left Tyre and went up to Sidon before going back to the Sea of Galilee and the region of the ten towns. A deaf man with a speech impediment was brought to him, and the people begged Jesus to lay his hands on the man to heal him. Jesus led him away from the crowd so they could be alone. He put his fingers into the man's ears. Then, spitting on his own fingers, he touched the man's tongue. Looking up to heaven, he sighed and said, "Ephphatha," which means "be opened." Instantly the man could hear perfectly, and his tongue was freed so he could speak plainly. Jesus told the crowd not to tell anyone, But the more he told them not to, the more they spread the news. They were completely amazed and said again and again, "Everything he does is wonderful. He even makes the deaf to hear and gives speech to those who cannot speak." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Have you ever had something really exciting happen and you're just bursting to tell someone, anyone? It's almost like you don't mind who it is. Well, is our faith like that? Or our experience of Jesus? Are we bursting to tell others about the goodness of God, just like we heard in our passage? In the Bible passages today, Jesus goes to the regions of Tyre and Sidon, coastal cities north of Galilee and significant Roman ports. Tyre, about 20 miles south of Sidon, has a little island out from the main city, I guess a bit like the Isle of Wight, and Jesus did not want anyone to know he was staying there. But word gets out, and a Canaanite woman comes to ask for his help. Her daughter needs deliverance. And Jesus' response appears quite rude. He has come north, out of Galilee, for a bit of downtime. And certainly the text suggests he didn't want to be disturbed or even found. Maybe there was an unwelcome sense of interruption. Maybe we might get irritated if we're trying to relax and the phone rings or there's someone at the door wanting us to do something when we're right in the middle of something. So his reply seems quite rude, even hurtful, dismissive. His response is that she's like a dog compared to Israel's children, the Jews. And dogs were not necessarily beloved pets like they are today. On face value of the text, the woman seems to accept this slur, but her reply seems to turn it around. Even the dogs are allowed to clean up the crumbs the children drop. By her words, she doesn't claim any right, but accepts her need for grace rather than a demand in entitlement. And Jesus is amazed by this faith of even a crumb from the master's table is enough to heal her daughter. And then Jesus moves on, probably still wanting to escape, to find anonymity for a while, taking the long way round, further north, through Sidon, and then down towards the Sea of Galilee. And they, unspecified in the text, bring him a deaf mute, and Jesus takes him away privately, away from the gaze of others, and after healing the man, tells them not to tell anyone. And Mark's account tells us that you couldn't shut them up. The more Jesus ordered them to be quiet, the more zealously they proclaimed it. I wonder if that's the problem with the church today, that because we are encouraged to tell people about Jesus, we keep quiet. Whereas if we were told not to tell anyone what Jesus has done for us, we immediately want to. I think they call it reverse psychology. It's like when you tell a child, "Don't touch that," and they immediately want to. There's something inside of us that can't resist. I'm sure that you've all seen the agonies of the marshmallow test. If not, do look it up on YouTube. But actually, the key things in this story are that amazing things happened. Healing and deliverance. Real change that was visible and obvious and clearly miraculous and clearly really, really exciting. I wonder, are we quiet about God's goodness? Because in our experience, we don't see much evidence of Jesus at work. Or is it that we do, but because we're so used to reading about Jesus in the Gospels, it isn't as amazing or astounding anymore? Or maybe we don't feel worthy enough to ask for a crumb in fear of him saying no. But what about asking for another? Like the mother's request, or the people who brought the deaf mute to Jesus. Jesus hasn't changed. He is the same today as he was then. He is healer and deliverer. But do we truly believe that? Do we believe that Jesus can work in our lives today? Sometimes we may struggle with what we believe, but as the body of Christ, as the church together, this is our statement of faith. So if you wish to, join in with the words in bold. Do you believe and trust in God the Father, source of all being and life, the one for whom we exist? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Son, who took our human nature, died for us, and rose again? We believe and trust in him. Do you believe and trust in God the Holy Spirit, who gives life to the people of God and makes Christ known in the world? We believe and trust in him. This is the faith of the church. This is our faith. We believe and trust in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. As we've declared our faith together as the church, and we lead into a time of prayer. We're going to worship through song as we place into God's hands all the things on our heart.
Father, I place into your hands the things I cannot do. Father, I place into your hands the things that I've been through. Father, I place into your hands the way that I should go. For I know I always can trust you.
Father, I place into your hands my friends and family. Father, I place into your hands the things that trouble me. Father, I place into your hands the person I would be. For I know I always can trust you.
Father, we love to see your face, we love to hear your voice. Father, we love to see your praise and in your name rejoice. Father, we love to walk with you and in your presence rest, for we know we always can trust you.
Father, I want to be with you and do the things you do.
Father, I want to speak the words that you are speaking to.
Father, I want to love the ones that you will draw to you. For I know that I am one with you. For I know that I am one with you.
Let us pray together as we remember the words in John's Gospel. In this world you will have trouble, but take heart, I have overcome the world. Everlasting God, hear us as we pray in faith and focus on the needs of others as well as ourselves. We pray for the whole family of your church here in Southam. May all your people be built up in faith and demonstrate in their lives the gospel of Jesus Christ. May you give us courage at the times when we find it hard to follow you, and give us encouragement when we, like the disciples, face criticism for following the teachings of your Son. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, we pray for our local, national and world leaders. We pray they may lead us with wisdom and compassion. We bring before you areas of conflict in the world and ask that those tasked with negotiations consider the way forward with compassion. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, we worship you as the one who has given us this life and ask that you will help us to live it to the full. At home, may we be the friends and neighbours that we really want to be. Help us to spread the warmth of your love to everyone we meet. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Loving God, we pray for all those who are afflicted by physical, emotional, or mental illness. Help them to keep their eyes fixed on you and give them the courage to face the trials and temptations that may come. In a moment of silence, we pray aloud or in our own hearts for those on our mind at this time. Merciful God, we pray for all who are coming to the end of their journey here on earth and pray that they may come into your presence and kingdom. We pray for all those who have come before your face and now rejoice in the fullness of life eternal. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And together let us pray the prayer that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. As part of our Bible passage was about the people being excited by the way that Jesus was touching lives and the wonderful miracles that were happening. And that we are called to be light going out into the darkness of this world, thought it'd be great to finish with this fun song, This Little Light of Mine, I'm Going to Let It Shine.
This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
As we are sent out as light into the world, allow me to pray a final blessing upon you. Let the majesty of the Father be the light by which we walk, the compassion of the Son be the love by which we walk, the presence of the Spirit be the power by which we walk, and may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among us and remain with us forever. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of Christ. Amen.